I grew up just outside of Houston, and I didn't know that there was a lot of nature and natural spaces out there. But then I started noticing and I started looking, and I just found it all over the place. I happen to live in the back of the subdivision next to a creek, and so I spent all my time exploring and being outside in the woods, and then I found out that you can actually make a living at being a wildlife biologist. So that's how I got started. A lot of folks hear urban wildlife and they think grackles and raccoons, but our urban areas are full of natural spaces. They're full of creeks and rivers and green belts. And when you put all that together, it's a matrix of urban wildlife habitat. So you need a good wide view of the trail. So as the animal comes in, it triggers the camera. Half a second later, the camera takes a picture, and now it's right in front of the camera. People care about the places close to them. My team can go out and help create more of those spaces for people to enjoy. It's an exciting thing because then other people will get excited about it, and then more people will be able to enjoy it. And the more people that enjoy it, the more they want to protect it.
It's exciting to be able to come in and see the different kinds of representation that are out there that represent diversity in Texas parks and wildlife. People begin to get engaged and be able to give back that experience and bring more diversity into the wildlife field.
What Richard has done for the diversity of our human capital at Texas Parks and Wildlife, especially within our conservation outreach program, is just hiring a diversity of staff.
Maybe the next time I go talk to a group, there's going to be some young person in there who's, you know, in an underrepresented group who thinks, you know, I could see myself being there and I could see myself doing this work. I think that's one of the things that's so exciting is about the opportunities for who we could be bringing to the table in conservation and wildlife work.
This program necessarily is really important, especially with inner city kids. And the most important thing that Richard has done for us in this is just his unwavering support of what we need to do. He is right there for us.
One summer I was doing a study and my cameras kept getting stolen. The only way I could fix that was to put it in poison ivy. And suddenly my cameras weren't being stolen anymore.
One of the things that I appreciate most about working with Richard and his leadership is that he's always been so incredibly supportive of his staff and the work that we're doing.
One of the challenges of having a very diverse constituency is being able to either have or understand the perspectives of all Texans. And one way we can do that is by training a diverse set of wildlife professionals.
There's a difference between a boss and a leader. A boss is someone that tells you what to do and how to do it, and a leader is someone who shows you what to do. And that's Richard.